My brothers, my sisters, tonight's motivation is for us to become people who know how to disagree with each other. We need to really understand disagreements will happen even among the best of people. It doesn't make the other person evil. We will disagree within our families. Be polite. Understand, it's okay. I can live with you with disagreement and I can be absolutely united. You know, when we say unity, when we say we're not united, and suddenly when you see everyone in Makkah making sajda together in ihram during Hajj, what do we say? Look how united they are. Do we not say that? Do we not say that? We see everyone's going to Arafah. Oh, look how united they are. Trust me, they are not united. They are not united at all. I know of people who go for Hajj with a lot of hatred for the others. I know of people who go for Hajj and they really don't like those others who are with them. But they're doing the same thing at the same time. That is not unity, that is uniformity. Don't mix the two. Uniformity is never unity. Unity is tolerating the difference. That is united. We can be united with everyone with our differences. Why? Because we have a common purpose. Somehow we need to protect this earth. We need to, for the sake of our children and our coming generations, let sanity prevail on earth. As time is passing, as we are progressing technologically, as we are becoming more sophisticated in our education, and you know, from a university degree to a master's to a PhD to a double PhD, subhanallah, we're becoming people who've lost our values and morals. We're becoming people who have lost the ability to interact with people in a respectful way, even though they differ very strongly, subhanallah. You can differ strongly, very strongly. I could differ with you totally, completely. I will still acknowledge you. I will greet you. I will respect you. I will smile at you. I will save your life if your life is in danger. I will make sure that I have served you, even though I differ totally. I might not agree. So what? So what? Subhanallah. You know, when you're driving down the road and something happens to you, you would expect anyone to stop and assist. Muslim, non-Muslim, tall, short, whoever else. Sometimes we're selective in who we help. That's bad. That's very bad. When the floods strike, they don't just strike people who thought the way you're thinking. They strike everyone. We become human. When something happens, when you have a natural disaster, it affects everyone. We would like to save all of humanity. That's why when Allah speaks of saving lives, He doesn't speak of Muslims. He speaks of an-nafs, the soul, the people. وَمَنْ أَحْيَاهَا فَكَأَنَّمَا أَحْيَا النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا. Whoever saves a single life is as good as a person who has saved entire humanity, because it's the feeling of the heart. I saved one life. Well, subhanAllah, if everyone had to follow that, the world would be a better place. So I pray that inshallah we can actually differ with respect. And we can actually learn to respect each other, love each other, care for each other, even with our differences. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all.